Everyone, today we're gonna create a simple MMV scene. For the start, you have to find the art that you're gonna be working with. In my case, I have a couch and the couch is cut off our scene, so I found this another one and I'll just drop a black and white on it and I'll use levels to create more contrast. Now this looks more like what we need. Let's start by cutting out our character. The best way to do it is just to pre-comp it. Go to the pre-comp and make the comp the way that you will see the full art, or at least the head. That's what we need the most. Let's start by cutting it out with the mask tool. For that, just select the layer and grab the pen tool and just press, make the start point, press to make the another point. If you want to curve it, you just press and hold. You can also press a couple of points, create a couple of points, and then press Alt and left mouse button to create the Bezier. Oh yeah, and another important thing is that your preview should be on full, because if it's gonna be on half or less, you will not see the borders as good as you will see it on full. I bless it that you have an open heart. I bless that you forgive. I bless it that you can learn from a loss. I bless it that you heal. I bless one day that you attract somebody with your mind exact. A patient life, flaws bless them twice, and they'll bless you back. Keep me torn and I'm on my walk. Rolling sevens, I ain't ready for no coffee. I know y'all love it when the dog's talking, but shut the fuck up when you hear love talking. Shut the fuck up when you hear love talking. God be the source, then I am the blood talking. Yeah, baby. Now once we cut out our character, there might be some stuff inside of the mask. So for example, like here, the stuff inside that you have to cut out. But as you can see, if you just cut something out, just like we did the first time, nothing's gonna happen. That is because we need to select the mask that we cut, the second one in my case, and we should press subtract on it. So it subtracts from the addition of the first mask. And we will do same for the other parts, like the right one. And another really important thing is when you cut out the mask, you have to select the layer. Because if nothing is selected, After Effects will just create a shape for you, and that's not what we need. So we've cut out our character. What we should do next? I will turn on my couch so I can fit it a little bit better. Well, it looks like crap, but still, I mean, we have something at least. So we're gonna start from the face animation, and of course people like to animate the eyes. In our case, since we're doing the manga, it's not gonna be hard, because I mean we have only two colors, black and white, and it's usually like not underexposed white, it's just plain white on the face. And for that we need to cut out our eyes. So we're gonna just duplicate the layer. We're gonna cut out the eyes, the first one and the second one. And we need a separate layer for the each of our objects. So for example, the first eye is gonna be our second layer, and the second eye is gonna be our third layer from those three duplicates. As you can see, I'm trying to cut out the eye without any, like, without missing all the dark parts. It's pretty important. Faded pictures, this global madness, the intervention, this world's in the twilight zone. This is the fifth dimension. God, please blow the whistle, we need an intermission. My good deeds in front of your door, I'm standing by the entrance. With heavy baggage, my brother's ashes, I seen tragic. I did dirt, smacked death, and held it to that nigga cabbage. No, we killing greed, we killing homelessness, and now I don't give a fuck. Once we got the eyes cut out, we should create duplicates of each eye. And below those layers, we should drop a fill. And fill is gonna be white. Same as the second eye, fill, and put it on white color. Now if we turn off the eyes, as you can see, we have plain white. And this is really important because once the eyes close, they create some skin behind. And if we don't have those white layers, I mean, it's gonna be pretty bad. After we cut out our eyes and created the white planes, we're gonna have to precompose our eye layers, and then, and after that, we're gonna separate our eyes on three separate parts: the top part, the middle part, and the lower part. So it's gonna be much more easy to animate. Hey, hold on, when it drop, get the sticks, get the mop. Flow sick. We're gonna grab this tool, it's called Puppet Pin Tool, and we're gonna place a couple of dots on our top part. After that, if you press U, you will see all the created keyframes. We're gonna move around 7 milliseconds, and we're gonna move those parts down. Not all the way down, because the lower part should be closing up too. So as you can see, it animates like this. We won't need the puppet pin tool for our middle part because it's just gonna move up. So we're gonna take position, move it up a little bit. The bottom part is gonna be like the top part, but it's gonna be just a little bit less of movement. And as you can see, we have the eye animation. All we need to do after that is just take our first keyframes and paste it in our timeline so it repeats. After that, we can use any graph. I mean, I can just easy ease it. And this is what it looks like. So if we go over here, this is gonna look like that. If you have problems, like the middle part is going out like this, you can create a mask. Just pre-comp the layer, and after that you can just create the mask like that and animate the mask. So to animate the mask, you just press M, open mask path, and create keyframes. I think I just dropped the marbles. Now we're going full throttle. I think I just dropped the marbles. Now I'm feeling so awful. I think I just dropped the marbles. Now I'm going full throttle. I think I just dropped the marbles. Now I'm feeling so awful. These fears, I need to face my fears. Gotta get back there. Go around over here. Cigarettes, no filter. Old soul, but I don't wither. Scared of souls, yeah, I get jitters. Mask off, no, but I ain't a killer. So as you can see now, we have the eyes animation. And, I mean, it looks pretty good. We can also make her mouth move a little bit. For that, we're going to do a really similar process. Just cut out the mouth. So let's pre-comp our eyes so it doesn't disturb us. Rolling all over cause I dropped the marbles. Three goons like Mitsubishi, how artful. Balls to the wall, yeah, I ain't careful. Pull up with the goons, y'all black Tahoe. Slip and slide on the ground, no home alone. Bitches got me fucking bit like scrap auto. Next thing that we're gonna do is cut out our hair. And this is gonna be the most hard part because we have to match up all the lining and stuff and the geometry over here, but you can do it in Photoshop, but we're gonna try to do that in After Effects. Let's pre-comp our mouth and eyes just out of the way, and let's select our layer and create a duplicate again. Now we're gonna cut out our hair with the masks. Sippin' a wine, yeah. Posted with my brother, yeah. He got the- So we've cut out the hair and we're gonna do the fill again, but with white color. Let's turn everything off except the hair, and we're gonna match it up with the things that we have here already, the white layer. So as you can see, if we turn on the alpha channel, we can see it better since the black lines don't mix with the black color. And we're just gonna add like a little bit of elements, like a stroke, for example. Never get you put that side of purple light lean. I try to fuck in the dot and sip on some lean. I try to fuck in the dot and sip on some lean. I love all my dice and Goldie. I love all my dice and Goldie. I'm a rock star bitch, this what I bleed. Nigga try to play me, I'ma make him bleed. Yeah, I'm in the cool with a cutter, yeah. Sippin' a wop, yeah. Post it with my brother, yeah. He out the mall, yeah. Post it with my brother, yeah. Now I think everything is pretty good. Everything is pretty set up. But I don't think why my mask did not cut this out. Oh yeah, it did cut this out, but in the wrong way. We have to subtract. Yes. And as you can see, our top head. If we move this, if we turn this on and move, pre-compose the shape layers, all the shape layers, and move it close to the white background that we created. Now, as we can see, if we move the anchor point, you can press Y and move the anchor point anywhere. If we move it like where the neck turns, I think it's a little bit like under the nose, I guess, on this, in the certain view, I think it's a little bit lower, like over here. Now if we rotate the head, I mean, we still have the back part of the head. I think we should get this cut off. So I think you might get confused, so I will just try to explain it a little bit more detailed. We have the background part, like the whole thing with face, eyes and stuff. Then we have those eyes and mouth. Then we have the head with the eyes and mouth. Then we have the white part of it. I mean, not the white part, the strokes and the lines that we need for like a realistic view. And after that, we have the whole thing. And from this whole thing, we gotta just cut out the head because we have that already. So if we turn the head now, there's gonna be one problem. First of all, some stuff over here, and the eyes and the mouth. For eyes and mouth to stick to the head, we just gotta connect them, like with this thing, to our head. So this is the eyes layers on the top, and below it is the head layer. We just connect it, and now everything rotates as it needs. The only problem is this this thing. We can just like use the mask to get rid of it, same as over here. Like if we rotate the head other way, there's just gonna be some stuff that we just need to like ease up, like that. I guess we should just create a rotation on the third second, like that. And I think it should be pretty fast graph, like that, or even more. So basically with Puppet Pen Tool, you can create any animations, and we talked about it, like we created the eye deformation and all the other stuff. We're gonna deform some parts of the body and some parts of hair. Spirits float around in my room, I feel haunted. Seeing in your eyes, baby girl, I know you want it. If it's about to rest, hell yeah, bitch, I'm on it. Wanna be a star, baby, lights, camera, action. Hit it from the back, stretch it out like elastic. I be rocking out, finna fuck on a bad bitch. See, I can't fuck, get that hoe, not the baddest. Dish it up the top, no, I don't need to practice.
That bitch like a blunt, hit her once, then I pass it. In that Hellcat, yeah, that bitch go the fastest. Married to the racks, it's a fatal attraction. She say I'm a dog, but all dogs go to heaven. Bad yellow bitch, yeah, she pretty, but she deadly. Posting my DM, she can't help but get jealous. Hit him with the chop, make him dance, just like Elvis.
Does not move naturally the other way, so I'm just gonna be the lazy guy. I'm just gonna pay the keyframe on that. And just because I'm lazy, I hope you are not lazy. So this is what it's gonna look like. I'm going to animate the position right now with the scene. Let's pre-comp this. Fun fact, if you pre-comp a layer and then you try to scale, you know, scale or position, there's basically a border, so you basically created a new composition inside this thing. You can press on this thing so that you can see what's inside, basically, and it's gonna save you up a lot of time. So guys, I will just animate the camera, I mean the position and everything else for the start of the video. I hope you have a great, wonderful day. This was our first tutorial, so we're a team of people who create videos for you. I hope you knew that. Have a great day.